I have made a lot of work on the Universal Lego Sorter. In the last update, there was just a slide with some small rails and a conveyor belt with some pretty cool structural supports underneath. Now I have changed a lot. Since last time, there is now a flap instead of a gap for where the bed meets the conveyor belt. This just allows for parts not to slip through as easily, especially little parts. I haven't had any problems with little parts slipping through the current design. And down here, there's these really cool braking mechanisms, which is basically just like a cushioner for this big counterweight, which ensures that the little flap slams down fast enough for parts not to slide through. This new part of the machine is the second conveyor belt. It's got some pretty cool features to ensure that pieces don't bounce out. As the conveyor belt is constantly under tension, it sort of absorbs the shock of pieces hitting its surface, making sure that they don't bounce around. For this second smaller conveyor belt, it was really all about enclosing it with pieces so that the pieces don't bounce around, because it is a hopper in of itself, and then also enclosing it as much as possible while still allowing these little bumps on the tracks to go through and the big beams on the large track to fit past it as well without bonking into any of the pieces on this second section. Now, after finishing the conveyor belts for this machine, I decided to just build up a quick prototype of the shake table. In the original Universal Lego Sorter by Daniel West, he used the Lego Buggy motor, which is the most powerful Lego motor ever made, and this allowed him to have it spin fast enough to get a really smooth vibration. However, here I'm just using oscillating Technic beams, and they pretty much have a similar effect with a powered up large motor. For future iterations, I'm thinking about having the vibration mechanism farther towards the back by where the pieces fall on, so that the vibrations get mitigated as you get closer to them falling off the end, and then also having stronger vibrations to knock bigger pieces like Technic beams off of each other. I've added these flaps, which serve the purpose of preventing pieces from bouncing out onto the vibration feeder before the pieces are ready, and then also allowing it so that when pieces do fall off the end of the conveyor belt, they're pushed sort of straight down by these heavy flaps. And the flaps have weights at the top, as you can see, so that the center ones can fall back into place pretty quickly, while also being light enough so that pieces can push them so that they're not holding pieces back on the conveyor belt.